can we have our next performer who goes by the name of, I have to see, who goes by the name of Simran Singh. He's new here, please give it up for him. Please be encouraged.
Good evening, everybody. I'll start with a very painful personal declaration. My name is Simran, and I'm not a girl. You know, you would all agree that our identities are defined by our names, right? But what does one do when that very name becomes a bane of your life? Because in my case, that's exactly what happened. It was all okay up until 1995, when the teaser of an upcoming movie came on television. Tujhe dekha to ye jana sanam. And boom, came the rudest shock of my life on screen. Kajol as Simran. When Raj met Simran, love was never the same again. Fucking hell, my life has never been the same again. Because after that day, every second girl child born in the country was named Simran. So you had Simran Bhatia, Simran Arora, Simran Ranganathan, all the way down to Simran fucking Mascarenhas. I'm not kidding, these people exist. You know, next year, for my summer vacation, I went to my dad for to ask his permission to go on a vacation, and even he got filmy. He said, Ja Simran, Ja. Guys, there are times when I've called up a restaurant for a dinner reservation and they would ask me, whose name should we book the table, sir? I said, my name, Simran. Sir, is it a special occasion for her? You get stressed out and you call up a spa for a massage appointment and they say, in whose name? My name, Simran. Sir, we only have male therapists. Would she be okay with that? Guys, I gulped it down. I've been living with this pain all this while. To the point it started affecting my professional life. 1 month into my first job and my boss calls me and says, Simran, you're failing to meet client expectations. Every time you tell the client that Simran is going to come and assess your needs and provide you our services, they expect a hot Punjabi bombshell to walk in and they see this guy. Obviously, entire value proposition goes out the window. Guys, I even contemplated marriage, but then I backed out. Because I did not want my wedding card to read like a lesbian wedding card. Imagine Simran gets Kiran. Simran gets Devika. Guys, I mean, section 377, all the shit might be happening, but it's not fucking legal to get married, right? I talk about another interesting concept. How many in the room have lived abroad, traveled abroad? Only one race, guys? Only one? Guys, the concept is that whenever we travel abroad, we come back with an accent. We're Indians, we're entitled to it, right? And the concept is that the shorter the duration of your stay abroad, the stronger that is. Isn't it? So I have this friend. She lived in the US for about 6 months and obviously came back with a very strong accent. And she loves to sing. So this is how she goes. Now imagine, if the original singer of this song was to hear this rendition, how would she react? Probably something like this.
भाई और बहनों, संगीत की दुनिया में आज मैंने 60 वर्ष पूरे किए हैं, पर आज तक मेरे गाने का इतना भद्दा मजा किसी ने नहीं उड़ाया। मेरी आपसे याचना है कि चाहे तो पेडर रोड पे फ्लाईओवर बनवा लें।
Lata ji, how can Asha ji be far behind? I have a fucked up mind, right? So I keep thinking that what happens when people from the same vocation get married and they have sex? Like what must be happening when RD and Asha have sex? So they're deep into the act, right? And Asha goes, ah! And RD says, Asha, sur mein nahi ho. And Asha ji won't be left far behind. So Asha says, aapka bhi pancham khada nahi. That was my statement, gentlemen. Thank you.